I'm going to assume it's like a path, but I'm not sure. We could try out something else after this is done. So yeah, this is basically rounds based, and you have goals. Yeah, we have a basic food that we have population, like a population maximum. Hierakonpolis is actually a Greek name. This is not an Egyptian name, but yeah, it's in ancient Greek. So the way in which this game works is that we have these tiles on a map. Over here we have like one food. So this worker is now working on one food. And there's always like these little fancy animations and stuff and graphics. The entire rest of the map here is behind the fog of war. We first need to discover it. So now that we set this worker over here to scout, they will take one turn to uncover this area. Our mission is colonization. And this is the stage of development that we have. It's a bit out of date, but this game takes use of the like the sort of view of history as a staircase or like a sequence of steps. For further development we should discover the Badari culture. This one is real. Like there's, of course, we are playing like a fictionalized version of Egypt here, but there are references to actual things in this game. What I mean by fictionalized is that while, like, of course, like Egypt exists and all of the regions of Egypt and all of that, the way in which we play is up to us. And over here we are actually producing a little bit more food. Which is actually interesting, because over here you can see we are gathering fruits, basically, or like we are gathering food, like vegetational food. Whereas down here the icon indicates hunting, so this is also like a this is a little bit, like, it's a small thing that you can notice, but it's also a kind of framing of where this is going down. From, like, hunting to gathering, and then from gathering we get to agriculture at some point. And yeah. These buttons down here are like creating and dismissing workers. It does look like apples a little bit. If we zoom in, it's just a little bit indescribable, but I mean, it's possible that it's apples here.
Hey, ah.
So now that we have a second worker, this one is using up one more food, of course. So we can either send them over here to gather food, or we can send them out to scout. And of course, different areas require different amounts of time for scouting. If we gather more food, we could hire more workers, but we won't have any tiles to work them on. So I think I'll send this one up for scouting. Production and culture. Like this, the idea of like production and culture being linked with each other, it's like an easy concept. Think of things like material cultures like pottery and craftsmanship. We have been attacked by jackals. Yeah, that's also... this game also has, like, events. They seem weak. And they are behaving fearlessly, it says. I'm not sure if there's, like, variation in this game that, like, you can have different results just by chance. So we can just try it out. If they are weak, that could mean that they are easier to beat. But I don't know if there's like a chance of us still missing. Also, yeah, the more workers we have, the more costly the next one is going to be. And we can make a discovery. We have plus one food. And these look like goats, so this is very appealing. This is very appealing, not because it's food, but because there are goats. This would give us more, like, piety or whatever. Yeah, I think I'll take the goats. Yeah, it actually also... I didn't even see that, but it also says that. But hey, that's... that's a good way to develop a game. You indicate something visually, and then it just says it. Also, yeah, as you can see, the cost is like for, I don't know, authority or piety. I think it's authority. So authority or whatever, that's the currency in this game of discoveries. Or culture, yeah, culture it is. Authority is another resource, but it will be enabled only later in game, I think. Neolithic Revolution. So thus far we were in the Mesolithic. Our goal is to discover farming. The idea of not using much words, but instead pictures to describe what... Yeah, that's actually something you see... you basically see this everywhere in the world, in like the... going back all the way to the Paleolithic, really. Like, drawings. And in some cases, symbolic, abstracted drawings of things like animals or processes like hunting. Things like using words to describe what you want to say is something that only emerged much later on with, as far as I know, first like the Phoenician alphabet and for instance Chinese also, like ancient Chinese also had a sort of written language, which you can sort of see with many of these like very old first writing styles, that they are in some cases also abstractions of things. I believe if we uncovered this, it would actually also uncover the river. Which I'm going to just assume that the river is also a food source, which would make sense. Yeah, drawings and symbols are much easier to understand, that is true. They are easier to understand, they are also like... conceptually speaking, because they are easier to understand, they are also more universal. So, like for a while, you would still be able to much easier communicate with people in your surroundings, even if they like had different mannerisms to express different things. While I do know that there is a optimal way of playing this game, I do hope that it's not too punishing if I'm not doing that. So these are global goals. Yeah, restaurants is actually a good idea. Like, that's a space wherein the use of images has seen sort of a resurgence. The use of images does help not only like... Well, I mean, the big thing in which it helps is exactly like when people don't speak your language, or when they're foreign, or to like remember things easier. It's like different aspects. This now produces production. For this we need experimental farming. I think I do want to do some more scouting. The greening of the Sahara was actually a thing that was that occurred. Like there's periodic, there's periods of the Sahara greening. Right now, IRL, the Sahara is basically a one big desert. The word Sahara means desert, basically. But during the Paleolithic, and I think still like up until in like the grand scheme of things, recently, it was like a savanna-ish space. So now we can improve tiles. And there are hostile tribes here. The myth about the ancestor falcon. This is Assassin's Creed now. Oh, now we don't have enough production to do the upgrade. cows. So we just need 5 pop. For the next pop we need 22 food. This will be reached in 3 turns. Yeah, three turns. Hello, monument. How's it going? How I found the game, I just randomly found out about it at some point, and now I'm playing it for the first time. I know that there is an optimized way of playing it, but I just want to do it like a chill playthrough, basically. I don't want to like dig up how to best play this game right now. Also, something which I do like about this game is like the graphical style. That one is neat. Sort of the idea of a game like this could be applied basically about everywhere in the world with most... Yeah, like at least like a fair amount of periods. Worker limit, yeah, we have reached the pop limit. Plus 5 culture, 5%. Well, actually 5% of 7 is not a whole lot, like that's not noticeable at this point, I would say. On the other hand, plus 2 food is noticeable at this point. Aboriginal Australia, that is also interesting. I'm going to have to look into whatever there. Yeah, 5% is not much right now, but I'll have to look into that Aboriginal Australia. Actually, because we are at the pop limit, probably dwellings are going to be best. I actually didn't check if this is on normal or on easy. It's my first time playing. I'm just going to see where we will end up at. Everywhere plus one culture, this could be good. Hunting and fishing plus two. Or we could have gathering, farming and cattle breeding plus one in 3 turns. I believe maybe this one is going to be best for fathers. I think the last game that I played that had something to do with Egypt was Assassin's Creed Origins, which has a pretty neat sort of discovery tour, which is like guided tours basically. Albeit if you like games that have to do with the if you like the Paleolithic, Meso, Neolithic and so on, then if you also like stuff like Banished, for instance, then Dawn of Man could also be something. Okay, let's see. This over here is a lot more productive than this tile at the moment. Like this, we can also finish our building. And we can actually afford another worker, I think. Technically. I haven't yet tried out ancient cities. I know that it exists. And I know that ancient cities is still being developed, unlike Dawn of Man. Oh yeah, I didn't even pay attention yet. You're right. I will be of. It's pop limits. Pop limits have been haunting me since, I think, Age of Empires 2 back then. Thank you. so now we can increase our workers. Yeah, the trials. I think I will be conserving stuff for now. The Badari culture. They have a layer of nobility which indicates that they move towards the creation of a state. Strictly speaking, this only makes sense under a specific socio-economic historical framework that they need nobility for a state, but whatever. Sanctuary of the Falcon, so we can now pet them. So we need to build this. And we can speed it up. And we have plenty of food, so we could just do that. Now we are ahead of them. Free honor in the cult menu. Oh yeah, by the way, over here you can also see in the image, it has changed now with a sun disk, which, like, that's an indication of authority, the sun disk. Accelerate the building by 2 turns. can get either food or production. I think there will be a lot more food tiles than production because this is the Nile River, basically, or one of its arms. Also, I'm going to assume we'll need to do a lot more construction work. Yeah, we only have two turns left, so I think we'll finish it before them. Yeah, we have plenty of... We are plenty ahead of them. Interest in Egyptology... not specifically, I think. There are definitely interesting things about Egypt, but sort of my interests are like maybe in a generalized fashion, like history, but also geography and geology, which I am sort of a geographer and geologist by education, basically, a little bit. Just a little bit. But Egypt is also still an interesting area from like multiple perspectives as well. We have interesting things about its history, about like the geographical area. You have interesting things about geology. Something which interests me specifically, for instance, with Egypt is also, just as an example, like fossils, like for example, Spinosaurus is a dinosaur which was first sort of found and described in Egypt. That would have been the Bahariya formation, or Bahariya. Also something that interests me, but more like hobby, in like a hobby fashion, is also things like, for example, place names and etymology. Like that's just a random thing, because this game also has place names, and at least they actually say that it's in Greek here. Often what you see in games is place names which are used often, especially in like, especially if you go back in time, in like the classical era, etc., you have many place names which are written down in Latin or Greek, and then games will sort of just pretend like those were the names of those places. When, for example, one good example with this are Phoenician, like Canaanite, also like Punic place names, where games will very often just use Greek place names and pretend that those were the place names, even though those are, strictly speaking, exonyms by somebody else. So, for example, every game worth its salt would tell you that, for example, Carthage would be called Carthadasht. In this and Egypt Old Kingdom, sometimes they give the Egyptian or Arabic place names here, or explain in historical notes. Historical notes or like explanations, yeah, that's a good idea. It would, like in the case of Egyptian, it would be interesting to use like demotic names, for example, but even then still, even though demotic is Egyptian, sort of, I think it would still make sense to make like, as you wrote down, like making notes, stuff like that. Because often, it can often also be the case that the ancient Egyptian name, for instance, is not the same as Demotic. Because Demotic had Greek influences, for instance. Get a gold victory, complete the trial before round 34. I'm not sure that, I think that would have been possible, but I sort of slacked because, like, why would you be faster if you're already ahead of the others? For further development, we should discover clauses. Very unbased, very ratioed. Technically, it would make most sense to, like in real life, scout ahead along rivers, and instead of constructing here towards the right, you would rather want to construct along the river, like especially back in time, up until, strictly speaking, up until like the Roman Empire, or even the medieval age, and in many places in the world, even like beyond that point, rivers were not borders of countries. they were the place along which people would settle. It is sort of a modern invention to look at a map and look at a line or something like a river and decide that this should be your border. That's a very modern thing, really. Because rivers would supply you with like food, with drinking water, with waste disposal, with easy trade. Rivers used to be centers of life. Danube and Rhine was sort of a border for Rome. Yeah, that's what I said. It was like the Roman Empire. Actually, it's the mentality was a little bit like using those as borders, but even then it is actually not true to say that it was a border for the Romans. The Romans actually expanded, or at least attempted to expand, always beyond these borders. So, for example, the comparatively short-lived province of Danubia, Pannonia. Pannonia used to be across the Danube, or like within the basin where Hungary is today, sort of. And in terms of the Germans, like one of the reasons precisely why this great event, known as like the ambush in the Teutoburger Wald, why that happened was because the Romans extended beyond the River Rhine. Like, that's within the territory of like Germany, Teutoburger. Then again, Germany for the Romans was sort of like an Afghanistan for them, really. Tribe. They are advanced, they are hostile, they are weak, they have valuable goods for exchange. Subduing them would be 100%, which is pretty good, because there's no chance of failure, and it would cost 4 food, and we produce well enough food. I actually cannot stack this, but okay. If you're going, CU2, it was nice sort of chatting with you, I guess. Hope to see you whenever next time. Ha! 10% right now. Yeah, that could be good. Who is this? It is a meep.
Cow not.
Yeah, Newt is the cow god.
By the way, got roughly, yeah.
Roughly what?
65% in German today. It seemed to be that the problem this time is the difference between Vorum, Varum, Wofür, Woran, Wovon. Because it kept several times in a row asking me, but how would one say what were you interested in earlier or versus what are you working on now versus what are you, like, stuff like that. Which is apparently, why does German have 8 different words for what?
I was just talking without the stream hearing about it. Because your voice is recorded by the stream, by the way. It's because German is more complex than what. If you ask Wovon, you're asking of what. Or if you ask Wofür, it means for what.
How's an easy way to remember it?
Like, I would just remember it like this. Like, if you could ask something in English, like, for what are you using this, for example, like, then it would be Wofür, benutzt du das? Like, if you can ask for what, then it is for what in German. Or if you can ask of what, Wovon, of what.
Of what is this made of? Or is that not really a...
Of what place is this? Is you can ask this, for example, like I don't know right now how to describe it. I'm thinking about other things playing this game.
But Wofür is of what?
For what? Or wait, Wofür. Yeah, it's for what? Wofür brauchst du das? For what are you needing this?
And Wovon is of what?
Wovon is of what? Wovon wurde dieses T-Shirt produziert? Of what was this T-Shirt produced? And then you would answer something like flex.
Yeah. Woran?
It's actually also like asking for a source. Woran hat's gelegen? Of what was it caused? I guess that would mean in English.
So you can use Wovon and Woran interchangeably?
No, Wovon would be in terms of like materially, and Woran would, I guess, ask more like causes and effects. like Voron Seedmon does. From what are you seeing this? Like, what is the cause of why you are seeing this?
Okay. I'm just irritated that, like, a couple of days ago I was getting, I think I was getting, yeah, between 80 and 90% day after day, and then suddenly today, new week starts 67%. Just because of those specifics. Because it didn't like me just using Varum.
Actually, Varum, you can... Varum and Voron, you can use this for meaning the same if you change the structure of a sentence, I guess. I don't know. I'm thinking about, like, I'm trying to think of examples.
The examples that Duolingo wanted me to translate was, for example, applying for something. Like, what are you applying for? What would be... Wofia... No? Would that be Wofia? Wofia bewerbst du dich?
Yes. You can ask it like this. Wofür bewerbst du dich?
And it happened in my head again. I was... Like, even Wolf, even if Wolfweed is the correct thing, the first thing I think of that is wrong for some reason, I say in my head. It's also very close to a Swedish word, which means something completely different. Varför means why. For some reason. and for some reason I read Wolfir and I think Varfir, the Swedish one. No, but it's a compound word in Swedish as well, because it's var meaning actually where, and fear being for, so wherefore, I guess.
Wo für is the same in German, like where is wo and for, yeah.
But in Swedish, it just means why. You can only use it for like asking someone, but why, sort of. If you're describing therefore it is that, then it's därför. Which mean therefore, essentially.
You could say the same, I guess, for German, like dafür, therefore. But you can also say for that.
Thank you.
Yeah, the drying of the Sahara. That was also a thing.
Offering.
You cut off.
You cut off.
You cut off.
Let me change my internet access because it's. I don't understand. Should work now. I like how I did that and it went quick enough so that Discord didn't disconnect.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh yeah, by the way, a little trivia, the Nubians were called, or like the land of the Nubians was called Tar City.
Tar City. Tar.
Tar City.
Tar City.
We can buy ivory, ostrich eggs, I don't know how that works. Rare animals.
I've actually seen someone cook an ostrich egg and try to eat it as if it was just a regular cooked egg. Apparently they're really... how would I say this? Chewy. And that it's very, very meaty, sort of, even though it's just an undeveloped egg.
I mean, it is protein.
Yeah, but apparently they cooked one ostrich egg and they had like 3 days worth of breakfast.
Thank you. This can be a very strong tile. Actually, it would make sense that a that like a tile, or I guess a district with like a military four or something at this day and age would also give you construction, because in their off time, and like soldiers had a lot of off time, they would be craftsmen. At least in like places where you didn't have this sort of levy system, or if you know what I mean.
I don't know what a levy system is.
A levy system is where you will conscript sort of the peasantry to fight for you.
Oh that.
Yeah, it's not a militia system. It's not a system where these people will get training or anything. You will just like order them to assemble. I actually need to BRB. so
we're careful.
No.
Watch my little pog gems do their work.
Pog gems.
I am bleated to be back.
Bleed into my mouth.
That would be funny.
One of your followers is a protogen. Scroll down and there's a thing where your most recent followers and one is a protogen.
Cancelled.
Protogens are cute, but it's just... eh.
Yeah, sure.
There is like a subsect of like NFT or tech bros, tech bro furries that uses protogens primarily for some reason.
When you were beginning that sentence with NFTs.
Yeah. Otherwise, a lot of them are chill as well. Goatmosphere.
Yeah, that's Oli. Go atmosphere or go atmosphere.
Yeah, in Gothenburg, Sweden's most popular amusement park is located in Gothenburg called Liseberg or Liseberg. But one of the rides is called Atmosphere, but it's spelled atmosphere, but people pronounce it at most fear. And I think that's because. Or rather, that's what it's supposed to be, at the most fear, or something. Have you ever ridden a roller coaster that has loops?
I am not really somebody who goes to amusement parks.
I was just wondering. I've like ridden roller coasters at I think like 5 times the most in my life. And it's like, huh. Even the smaller one, like I think in one of the roller coasters I even hurt myself. So I think I like bit my tongue or something. It was years ago.
I have destroyed the Pepe tribe.
A frog. A frog. Arga, wie viele Sprachen kannst du eigentlich? Sprache? Wie vielen Sprachen kannst du eigentlich sprechen? Is that... I don't know.
You made one mistake. Did you notice which one?
Wie viele... I said wie vielen for some reason.
Yes.
Wie viele Sprachen kannst du eigentlich sprechen?
That is a correct sentence. Ich kann 3 Sprachen sprechen und kenne Wörter aus unterschiedlichen weiteren, wobei ich von den 3 Sprachen Deutsch und Englisch gut spreche und Französisch zu einem...
Horrible!
What did you want to say?
Oh no. I think the internet is going again. Okay, try to say something.
Je sais parler français, mais... Did you hear that?
Hello?
Coucou.
Okay. Like, you cut out, like, 10 times in, like, the last 10 seconds. It was interesting.
I mean...
And also, the stream, like, started buffering, like, every 2 seconds for some reason as well.
Yeah, it's entirely on your end, I can tell you that.
Hmm. Now it's versus losses. Oh,
we Palestine. Paphiris and Diospolis, those are also Greek names. I wonder if it's just me, but the background chatter for the background, like audio cues above the city, it sounds to me like I'm hearing English somewhere there in the background. It could be that they just made some sort of sound file with a recording from some random city, IRL. Thank you. Could use more food. Thank you. the goat tribe. This is me.
Thank you.
Ett nätverksfel har uppstått. Försök igen.
Guess on that.
That button doesn't even work.
What's now going on?
I think my Discord crashed at the same time that Twitch crashed. Also apparent. Also apparently it takes 5 seconds from me pressing the talk button for it to actually recognize me pressing it.
5 seconds. But for me it's instant.
It's now, I pressed the button 5 seconds ago. I'm gonna release the button now, see how long time it takes for it to stop.
By the way, it would be good if you were wearing headphones, because there's a feedback loop in the background for you.
I am wearing headphones.
Yeah, but when you were talking beforehand, it would catch your own voice. Or mine, on the stream.
Holy shit. No, like, when you are talking, it says you aren't talking, and now it went away. And now I have released the button, and it's not stopping the thing.
Yeah, that's a problem with whatever device you're using.
Windows, wait, let me disconnect first. I am connected, but now it takes 6 seconds for it to recognize me pressing the button, because apparently I have 1,000 milliseconds ping.
Filipino internet.
It says that this is the voice connection speed. It has no bars. Did you see it?
No, and now I will not look at it.
Okay, so it's weird. I'm listening back on the stream and it's instant when I press the button, but see there. Did you hear that noise?
No.
I'm speaking now. I'm holding in the button. There.
Yes, now I heard it.
This is how long it takes for it to recognize me pressing the button for some reason. Yeah. I think I broke my Discord. Sorry, I had muted the stream so that it wouldn't feed back, so I didn't hear that it was actually working when I pressed the button. It's only that on my end it only reacts after 5 seconds of me pressing the button. Okay, no, the entirety of Discord seems to be very fucked for me at the moment.
This guy is just like advancing his goat army. The age of man has come to an end. Now begins the age of Baal.
One more thing. Beep.
Beep. There needs to be some sort of indication that this is available for construction and this was already constructed, because just the text alone is not that much of a difference. Well, I guess you could still see that this is grayed out. I don't know, it would make it easier to see that this is available for construction if it had like a green border around it. Thank you.
Is it fixed now? No, it says that I have no voiced connection.
I can hear you.
I don't know, I suddenly no internet connection. I restarted the computer and because for some reason after I reconnected to the internet, Discord didn't want me to do anything. I couldn't connect to anything on Discord. And now I'm connected here, but it says I have no internet connection.
Right at this moment, I can hear you.
You just cut off. Okay, I can hear you.
Could we maybe not debug when
okay.
Stream?
Sorry.
Theoretically, you should never click flee in any game and in real life, because during military confrontations, most losses would happen during routes.
Any game?
If any game were realistic, then yes.
Okay.
Oh!
I think I will pick no.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Strong. Good.
Yes.
Thank you. Hey! Thank you. Thank you.
there.
What? What did you say?
There.
There means who?
The pie.
Oh, veja, or veja, yeah. In our dialect, you would say veja.
Thank you.
Thank you.